Welcome to Cell Clips. In this video, we'll be talking about how proteins get sent to various locations where they are needed in the cell. You're probably familiar with some of the unique functions of various organelles in eukaryotic cells. Organelles are able to specialize their functions by maintaining a unique set of proteins in a contained environment within the cell. However, proteins don't start out in the organelles where they are needed. They are first synthesized in the cytoplasm, and then, if they need to be transported, they are carried to various locations in the cell, such as the nucleus, the mitochondria, and the endoplasmic reticulum. Though transport to each of these organelles will look slightly different, there are four basic components that are present in all protein transport. The first component is a barrier. All organelles are surrounded by a membrane that is impermeable to large molecules. This allows specialized proteins to be contained within each organelle. But the membrane barrier also makes it impossible to import necessary proteins into the organelle. This problem is solved by the second component of protein transport, the gate. A gate is a pore or channel in the membrane that can be open and closed for certain proteins. This gate makes it possible to transport the necessary proteins into an organelle. But it presents a new passageway for unwanted molecules to diffuse in, or necessary molecules to diffuse out of the organelle. This problem is solved by the third component of protein transport, the gatekeeper. Gatekeepers consist of transporter proteins that bind specific cargo and carry them to the gate. These transporters then interact with gate proteins, causing a conformational chain that creates a pathway for the cargo to move across the membrane. There are unique gatekeepers for each organelle, which allows protein transport to be organelle-specific. But there also needs to be a way for very specific proteins to be bound by gatekeepers. This brings us to the fourth component of protein transport, the localization signal. Localization signals are short sequences of amino acids contained in a peptide with characteristic hydrophobicity or charge that varies depending on the destined location of the protein. Localization signals are often called zip codes because they work somewhat like an address directing the shipping of proteins to specific locations within the cell. Each transporter protein has high binding affinity for specific zip code sequences. There are many examples of localization signals directing protein transport. Each of these transport processes will be discussed in more detail in other Cell Clips videos. But for now, let's look briefly at a few zip code sequences. Proteins destined for the mitochondria are transported before folding, so their zip code is most often found at the N-terminus and is usually cleaved after transport. This signal sequence contains an alpha helix that is amphipathic, meaning one side is hydrophobic and the other side is hydrophilic. Gate proteins in the mitochondrial membrane bind to this sequence at high affinity and facilitate transport of the protein across the membrane. Proteins destined for the ER can be transported either before or after protein translation is complete. Some ER proteins have a zip code at the N-terminus, which allows transporters to bind and carry the protein to the ER before translation is completed. These zip code sequences are usually cleaved after transport. Other ER proteins are translated completely before transport, so these proteins can have signal sequences embedded in the middle of the peptide. Regardless of the location, the ER signal sequence contains a hydrophobic domain flanked by two hydrophilic domains. This sequence is bound by a transporter that takes it to a receptor in the ER membrane. Proteins destined for the nucleus are folded before transport, so their zip code sequence can be found in various places in the peptide and does not get cleaved after transport. Nuclear localization sequences contain positively charged amino acids, like arginine and lysine. This sequence is bound by importins that carry the peptide to the nuclear pore and interact with channel proteins to facilitate transport of the protein across the nuclear envelope. For organelles to carry out unique functions, they need to maintain a specialized environment within the cell, such as different pH levels or ion concentrations. Organelles also require unique sets of proteins to carry out their various functions. Maintaining these specialized environments requires four components: a barrier that prevents diffusion of large molecules, a gate that allows certain proteins to be transported in and out, a gatekeeper that selectively facilitates transport of specific proteins, and a zip code or signal sequence that is recognized and bound by transporters to ensure the proper shipping of proteins in the cell. This localization system is fundamental to any protein transport in the cell, so keep watching for zip codes as you learn about more cell processes. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching Cell Clips.